Hi, partly metal, partly real. It's my hips pretty soon. Andrew, and this is Gayties Boys. On today's MIA 80s, ladies, we're going to be talking about SilverHawks, which was the 1986 cartoon from Rankin-Bass, as well as the Kenner toy line from 1987. SilverHawks itself has really two main women in the cast, one being one of the SilverHawks, Steelheart, as well as Melodia, who we'll be talking about today. She was the one who did not get the toy in the toy line. And generally, you know, I kind of blanket sexism as the cause. Not so this time. Following their success with Thundercats, Rankin-Bass decided to do not exactly a spin-off, but another cartoon in the same vein, this time SilverHawks, which featured Commander Stargazer recruiting several people to be these kind of almost silver-plated, bionic, partly metal, partly real, hawk-themed heroes, and they were to be dispatched against Monstar and his mob of villains. Very paint-by-numbers, but, you know, somehow they managed to stretch it out for 65 episodes, so good on them. While SilverHawks wasn't technically a spin-off of Thundercats, a lot of fans have, you know, kind of connected the dots, much like they have with Tiger Sharks, too. The three are really, you know, successful, semi-successful, semi-not-successful trinity of Rankin-Bass during the mid-80s. Likewise, with their line of action figures, LJN was going to make SilverHawks toys, but seemingly at the last minute they pulled out, and no one's entirely sure why. I've never been able to find proper, you know, explanation for this. However, Kenner did pick up the license in the end, which a lot of people do find strange, but turned out well enough for them. They created a line of, you know, very back metal, which we'll get back to, action figures, and much like superpowers, each of the characters did have their own special feature. Likewise, they created quite a few, but not all of the villains, and the one we're talking about today is Melodia. Melodia and her musical madness was introduced pretty early in the series. She was really one of the big heavies for Monstar and his little gang. She had a very unique look. It was very MTV, very much to try to capture that moment in time. She had sort of two-tone green hair, black mini, very, I would say, Madonna almost. I mean, she really kind of did try to appeal to sort of a pop star aesthetic. Whether she's derivative of Madonna or Gem on the Holograms, doesn't matter. She did carry a real wallop of a weapon, and that would be her Sound Smasher, which was this sort of keyboard synthesizer. As such, the usual thinking, the conventional thought, was that she'd be paired off as an antagonist to Steelheart. However, that wasn't the case for a refreshing change. Bluegrass from SilverHawks, the kind of blue cowboy guitar weapon carrying guy, was really more her rival in the show. And that's, it was rare to see, but it was also like just sort of, you know, fun to see as well. Admittedly, she didn't really strike a nerve with me. I mean, I'm pretty much a defender of most women on this list, on this entire playlist, but she kind of irked me a little bit. She was almost a little bit of a proto Harley Quinn with this very like high-pitched, scratchy voice. And even in terms of her cohorts of the 80s, you know, for example, Baroness or Evil-Lyn or even, you know, Fiorellina from Visionaries, a lot of them sort of used, you know, frankly, you know, sexual prowess and manipulation and betrayal to get ahead, to sort of overthrow their leaders. Melodia at least two times dabbled in, you know, breaking out on her own, but always defaulted back to Monstar. She sort of really preferred that kind of protection in numbers against SilverHawks, against Johnny 5-0, all that. So, you know, did every villainess need to be this femme fatale? No, but I mean, it would be better if she actually kind of at least stuck to her guns. Another conventional thinking is that you only have one woman per wave. So of course, Steelheart got featured in wave one of Kenner's toy line. That said, Melodia was absent from Wave 2. Wave 2 itself was very much pared down from the first wave. Not only that, but she didn't really get featured like some other villains, like Poker Face or Yes Man. And I think the reason for this isn't so much like, ew, girl. It's more that, ew, boring. These three characters in particular, they were sort of, you know, humanoid-ish. And they had, you know, powers or relationships with other villains, but a lot of villainesses generally don't get the big muscle, the big goofy, the big monstrous kind of treatment, the way the men do. So when you looked at wave one of the villains in Silverhawks, who had like molecular and like whatnot, like these were super fun, interesting characters. Frankly, much more interesting than the Silverhawks in many cases. So I feel just, you know, a washed up rocker chick was never really going to like jump on the toy line the way that her cohorts did. One other thing of note is that in 1987, there was a Thundercats live show at Carnegie Hall. It was advertised, you know, in very small markets, but it looked incredible. Just very much Cats vibes. It was, you know, live action, Thundercats, Gumby was there for some reason, Silverhawks were featured, and it looks like a big cast. I've looked for years for some kind of even grainy reporting of this thing. I could never find it. Melodia was, in fact, featured there, and looked, I mean, just spot on. I mean, if they're going to do a movie, go that route. If you've ever seen the commercial for this thing, it is awkwardly horny. Like, I don't know what the producers were thinking, but it's just very uncomfortably horny, and it makes me want to watch it more. Since the series and Toyland cancellation, Silverhawks has not really seen a lot of play over the years. Really, it's sort of, you know, it's second, you know, cousin, redheaded stepchild to Thundercats. Still very much associated with that all these years later, mostly by fans versus an official, you know, stance by the creators. But they're really, especially for Melodia, the only real play I can remember from recent memory was around 2008 when Lady Gaga first came around. A meme sort of circulated of Lady Gaga being compared to Melodia, and it was spot on because Lady Gaga was also, let's admit, a little derivative of 80s musicians. That said, in 2021, following, again, the success of Thundercats, Super 7 may or may not have purchased Silverhawks. They are now creating the Ultimate Alliance for them. They've gone through and created all the main characters. They've gone through quite a few villains. Melodia, time of date, has yet to be made. I am just tired of waiting. I have it on good authority that she's coming, but if you're watching from the future in fall of 2024 or winter of 2025, you know, you're pre-ordering her. She's fine. Don't worry about it. And that's all I got. Melodia is not really anyone I'm, you know, scrambling for. I think if I were collecting anything beyond just these new kind of chromed out toy versions of the Silverhawks that Silver 7 is doing, that I might be inclined to get her. But again, she's kind of a dull villain amidst very, very cool villains, very iconic villains from the 80s. And she sort of slinks in the background in that regard. So she's not really someone that's memorable, but I think, you know, Super 7 will be doing the correct thing when making her, especially the only other woman in the line. So I thank you for watching. If you like this video, like the video, share, comment, subscribe, all those YouTube-y things, and I will see you next time on MIA 80s Ladies.